Hey guys, I'm Jinx, and welcome back to The Expanse. I did try to turn off Steam achievements. Apparently there's no proper setting for it, but you just need to turn off the Steam overlay, period. Thing is, I had the Steam overlay turned off, but we were getting the notifications anyway. Now I turned it on and turned it off again and blah blah, so we'll see what happens, but I hope it's fixed.
Whoever took Colin's barbecue sauce is a lot braver or stupider than I am.
To whoever stole my barbecue sauce, I've narrowed it down. According to the fridge logs, the likeliest culprits are Arlen, Maya, Drummer. Turn yourself in. It will go better for you. Well, we didn't take it. And granted, I do think there is an equal chance that either Arlen or Maya took it. Where's Virgil, by the way? Somewhere in that direction. Interesting. Anything to look at? Nope. Oh, well, I guess, yeah, but I have you two to look at.
True belters take water, air, and sleep wherever they can find them. Say anything else about these two, but they are true belters.
Well, let's let him sleep in peace, then. Post? Well, someone's happy. All right.
Maya and Virgil learned a lot of Langbelta swear words in the past week. Khan seems to already know them all.
Langbelta and you. Some common phrases you'll hear when visiting the belt. Polite phrases. Oye is hello. Oye ding is goodbye. Forgut, please. Taki taki, thank you. Imtan nating, you're welcome. People and relationships. Belt Alor, residents of the belt. Okay, In Yellow, residents of the inner planet. Kopeng is friend, and Bossmang is boss or employer, informal. Okay. Expletives. Sabaka, well damn, mild expletive. Felota, any floating object. Okay, also mild expletive. Nkaka is excrement. Yeah, it's shit. Now, let's see what they wrote on, because that's gonna be the more interesting thing. I'm gonna need the read function though. Hold up. Here we are. Brought to you by yeah blah blah. Pasheng is fuck. Owala is fucker. Jimang is dick crooked. Okay. Nakangepenza is idiot. Well, Walla is inner lover, and Pasheng Fong is fuck off. Okay. Very cool. I'm gonna forget half of it. I've already forgotten half of it, and I'm gonna forget the other half in the next minute, but it's cool to read. Someone's in a good mood.
Now that I know the truth about Virgil, it's time to get some answers from him.
It really isn't. Look at him, he's so happy. Why would we ruin that? Come on. Just give him mushroom powder. Let's get it over with. Let's not do anything else, yeah? Well, that's a look.
What's on your mind, Captain?
UNN mushroom powder. Mushroom powder.
I found some mushroom powder for you to cook with.
Bursting with umami.
Oh, alright. In it goes, I suppose.
Exceptional. Thank you, Captain.
Get some rest, Virgil.
Will do, Captain.
I'm not gonna. Why would I? I sincerely don't care. Oh, why do you still have a thing? I guess maybe the HUD needs to go away and then your little mission marker is gonna go away, right? Talk to Virgil. Game! I don't want to! You know, I'm gonna talk to everybody else first. Fuck off. I don't wanna talk to him about his past. But I guess it's not a choice then. It's just a thing that happens. I don't know, man. What the? Maya? Are you in there? Let me have a look. Just put the camera through the fucking wall. All right. Oh.
Taking Cox's gun from him was as close to a captaincy ceremony as I'm likely to get. I was skeptical of Virgil's maggot farm that he claimed would be useful in the event of an amputation. He showed me.
Medical maggots? Why the fuck do we need maggots? Oh, that's new. Why do we need maggots? What the fuck? I mean, is that to, like, eat away infection? Because I think that's a thing, but, like, if the prosthetics aren't, I don't know.
Anderson Station changed everything.
Remembering Anderson Station. We're approaching another anniversary of the Anderson Station massacre, but while many Belters are focused on the future, the violence and cruelty of the UNN should never be forgotten. After a group of miners staged a protest over inhumane working conditions on Anderson Station, the UNN dispatched Colonel Johnson. His attacks on the station killed over 1,000 Belters, igniting fury throughout the belt. The UNN has denied reports that the station had surrendered prior to the assault. Colonel Johnson resigned from the UNN soon after, and has been working to advance the interests of Belters on Tycho Station. But whether or not Fred Johnson manages to make amends to the Belt, we should never forget the UNN's willingness to sacrifice so many Belter lives. Goddamn. Comms log? That's kind of hidden though, isn't it? Communication log. Incoming from Luna, 1 second. Connection Ceres dog. Incoming Luna again. Connection Vesta dog. Twice. The Artemis has infrequent communications with a number of stations in the belt. I'd expect a scavenge vessel to have more contacts, but either the belt has been emptied of scrap to salvage, or our former captain wasn't great at following up on leads. The unanswered Luna contacts may be for Virgil, who moved to the belt from Luna. Arlen and Rayan don't appear to contact anyone. Maybe they have a bounty on their own, of their own to worry about. Maya, apparently, hasn't been in touch with her family since she came on board.
God damn it, Rayan.
That was the fucking thing that was gonna come apart, right? That needed to be secured or whatever. I remember that. Oh, cargo bay. Ooh. Well, I don't want to go there just yet. Let's see. I think we still have another direction to go, don't we? No, wait. No, we don't, actually. Okay. Fine. Let's go talk to Virgil. Alright. Sorry, bro. I have a mission telling me to do this. Even though it is a side mission that I could ignore, but...
What's on your mind, Captain?
It might also just, like, progress, like, his story or whatever in general, so, yeah. I don't know how this works yet.
You served in the UNN?
As a medic, yes. It was the only way I could afford medical school on Luna.
Why did you desert?
Because I was finding it harder and harder to live with myself. Being stationed in the belt, I was surrounded by people in desperate need of my help. But because of the badge on my chest and the gun on my back, I was their enemy. One day, it became too much to bear.
Did you do something?
No. I never hurt anyone. I never raised my gun, not once. But what I saw taught me that there were two sides, and I was on the wrong one. I'm sorry, Captain. I hope that my actions on this ship can offer some amends for my past.
Why should I trust you?
No, that is not the question you wrote.
Everything I have to get away from my past and start a new life here in the belt.
I understand, but if there's anything else I need to know, I expect you to tell me.
Of course. Thank you.
Get some rest, Virgil.
Captain, is my UNN past going to be a problem for us?
You were stationed in the belt. That means you were occupying my home.
I know.
The way I see it, you're wanted by the UNN for desertion. I'm wanted for fighting them. Sounds like we're both on the same side.
Thank you, Captain.
All right, good. Yeah, okay, fine. I should have asked him immediately. Okay, fine. But it's all right. We just had two separate talks, that's okay. Is there... Give Khan the cigar. We'll do in a second. But let's look at the cargo bay first. Because I'm also guessing Maya is going to be down here. Plus, I haven't been down here yet. Are you singing? Are you the love interest for this game? Because everything so far is making it seem that way. Oh no, it's a music play. And you took the barbecue sauce. God damn it, I knew it. I knew it was you. It wasn't going to be Arlen. I knew it.
I suppose this is what downtime looks like for Maya.
Well, it looks fucking calming is what it does.
Hey, Cap.
Thank you.
What you did in the debris field was incredibly reckless. You disobeyed my order, and you put the whole...
Oh my god. You're fucking welcome.
I was getting to that. Thank you.
Anytime.
Khan seemed pleased with her prosthetic.
That's good. Although you realize we just took the most unhinged person on the ship. And gave her a bionic skull crusher for an arm.
I think if Khan wanted to kill someone, she could do it without arms or legs.
What are you listening to?
It's Martian music. You wouldn't like it.
I'll decide what I like and don't like.
Thank you. is a letter I keep that was sent from the front. I don't know if you're hurt or worse, but my heart hangs on these words you wrote. My dear love, I miss you more than these words could ever say. Though this war may take my body, my heart is yours. We will meet again. Go and see how the wind meets the hills. Hear my voice in each whisper. Look for me.
Well,
all right. Maybe I realized a little too late that it was looping, but it was. It's very Martian. It actually isn't. Sounds very just human to me.
It's a beautiful song.
My mom used to play it for us on the guitar. Half the time, she'd break down crying and not even finish it. It reminded her of my dad.
Let me guess, a soldier?
It's funny. I hate my dad. I hate the army he died for. And I hate Mars. But I still miss it.
I'll leave you to it, then.
Wait! About that moment in the airlock.
Yes?
Yes?
Are you feeling any better? I know you were pretty scared, given how tightly you were holding my hand.
Oh, alright. Oh, okay. That's how it's gonna be, huh?
I'm pretty sure you grabbed my hand in there.
Oh, sure. We can go with that if you want. I'm just saying, I'm here if you need to talk.
The only thing we need to talk about is your delusion of fantasizing about me.
I get it. It must be hard for the boss Meng to express her feelings. Especially to the hot Martian engineer who can totally kick your ass.
Not according to that scoreboard.
My point is, there's nothing to be embarrassed about. Even if you did clink helmets with me.
Clink helmets? What is that supposed to mean?
I think you know exactly what it means. Helmet clinker.
Typical dumb Martian. You try to kiss a woman, but forget to take your helmet off first.
If I did try to kiss you, there'd be no fucking confusion about it. You know, we could stand here talking about hands and helmets all night. Or we could go back to my room and settle it.
All right! No need to ask me twice.
By settle it, are you talking about sex?
Only one way to find out.
Okay. All right. Let's go. Chop chop. We have a room to get to.
Wow.
Yep. We have a room to get to. I will check this out later. Okay. Crew quarters. Oh, what the fuck? She's actually... Wait. Uh-huh. Yep. She's in there. Do I die? Okay, fine. I will come back later, because I am not missing that, in case that is the actual thing you can do. But goddamn. Alright. So what was I saying about... her being the love interest, because I kind of feel like my suspicions were confirmed.
Ah, Falota. Maya's the one who stole Khan's barbecue sauce. That is...
absolutely to be expected.
Not at all surprising, actually.
Yep. I guess we're going to leave it there unrefrigerated.
Honestly, I'm glad Maya finally got one. This was starting to get sad.
All right. This big ass cargo bay. Water storage log. How are we doing on water? Reserves 5%? Dude, we passed like entire fucking water containers on our last scavenging thingamajigger. We didn't think to fucking take any water. Average time between restocks last 18 months is 65 days. Average time between restocks last 5 years is 31 days. Okay. Rains like cost us a lot of supplies, but the lack of water is concerning. We'll need to plan to restock in soon. The water log shows regular intakes that have diminished significantly in recent years, meaning the Artemis once had a larger crew. Years of Cox's empty promises must have driven most of them away. If only I had stuck around for the MK Corps. Although they might have wound up clinging to the hull along with me. Yeah. And we don't even have the MK Corps yet. We don't even know what the fuck it is. It doesn't sound very good. Like, it's not gonna end up very good for us. So, yeah. A bunch of airlocks everywhere. Almost as if we're on a spaceship. Alright. I think that's everything to look at. In that case, what are things? Give Khan the cigar and talk to Khan. Right. Okay. Let me just do one quick pass. Okay. I don't think she's, like, waiting, right? I think it was just supposed to be, like, that exchange and then you just keep playing, they don't immediately throw a sex scene at you in episode 2, right? Right? Oh, am I? Hold, you know what? Fuck it. I'm looking it up. I am looking it up. Whew, all right. There we go. And I'm gonna fucking do it live. No, I'm not. See you in a sec. All right, I'm back. Let's continue playing. No, I'm not gonna tell you what I found. You're curious? Don't be. I have a suspicion you'll see in a sec. Which I guess might be more telling than anything else. Let's go back to the bridge. Give Con her cigar. That she can't smoke in here, but you know, just have her have it anyway. Another for her selection to chew on. Oh, that is not the way up, alright. Here we go. Hey, Con.
Hey, Con.
Resting. Go away.
I can see that you're resting, but I'm gonna talk to you anyway.
I found a cigar on the Urshinabi. Thought you might want it. But I could always give it to the twins.
Don't you dare give it to those two morons. They'd use it as a butt plug or something. First taste, you earned it.
Like, chewing on it? That's perfect. I thought we couldn't smoke in here and that's why you chew on your cigar, but I guess you chew on it because it's fucking already emptily smoked. Good.
Oh, Pashag. Tastes like burnt kibble.
That's your unrefined palate. You need to smoke more to burn away all the taste buds.
Right. Got a cool, graspy voice like you, right?
My husband, Bao, used to hate when I smoked. Said it was 40 minutes of pleasure for 3 hours of cleaning out the air vents.
He wasn't wrong. What happened to him?
The Pinafore, a small transport skiff owned by Trackman. I was pilot, Bao was chief mechanic. Boring work. Little outside contact. Exactly what we wanted. There'd been reports of pirates along our heading. The usual shit. We weren't worried because, what's the point? And besides, we had our protocol.
Protocol?
A maneuver we practiced. In case of hostile boarding, I'd feign submission, hands behind my head. And when Bao thought the moment was just right, he'd say the code word and hit the deck, and then... Modified SMG with heat-targeting rounds. I could draw and fire the clip in 5 seconds, easily take out an entire raiding party.
That is actually a solid tactical maneuver. Pirates wouldn't expect a weapon there, and Bao would be safe on the floor.
I know.
So what happened?
The pirates came for us like we feared. They boarded the Pinafore. I drew them in, got them occupied. and at the right moment, Bao said the word. And I froze. I'd never fired live rounds in battle before, and I suddenly doubted myself. What if the clip was jammed? Would it even fire? Maybe these pirates weren't so bad. It was just a moment. But it was enough time for an antsy pirate fuck to grab me and shoot my bow.
I'm so sorry, Khan. It sounds like you two really cared about each other.
That's the thing. We did. It's so easy to stop caring out here. Don't you want to know the code word? Artemis. I'd never heard of her. It was Bao who read all the Greek bullshit. Apparently, she and I shared a few things in common.
Great beauty?
Your godlike wrath?
That may have been part of it. Mostly, he said it was because I never missed my shot. Tell you what, if I ever get the chance, you bet your ass I won't flinch again.
Any guesses on our destination?
Nada. All I know is that it's far the fuck out there. So whoever hid that treasure wanted it far the fuck away.
Can you believe how vicious these pirates are?
Yes.
I mean, how they were willing to blow us up just to prove a point.
Yes.
So you don't think there's anything special about them?
Yes, I do. They seem to have more guns.
It's good talking with you, Khan.
Yeah.
It might be the first time those two actually had a conversation, right? Alright, maybe we should let you rest in peace. What is our mission? Hello? Mission board? Do you mind? Get some well-deserved rest. Aha! Some quote-unquote rest, huh? Okay. Sure, let's get some rest. Wink, wink. Alright. Crew. Wait, I need to climb down another ladder, don't I? No, I do not. Crew quarters. Oh, wait, shit, no, the wrong thing. Why didn't we change the name tag? I guess it's not my thing, I'm still down here in the crew deck, right? Even though we're the captain. I mean, I wouldn't really want to sleep in Cox's bed anyway. crew quarters, here we go. Let's get some rest.
If I sleep with Maya, the entire crew will know about it. Nothing stays secret on a ship like this. Is one night worth all the drama?
Well, is it just gonna be one night, though? That smile answered her own fucking question. I'm sorry, dude. I feel like this is our third choice in the game, and I feel like there's only been one that has actually been a little bit of a dilemma, and that is the first one with Rain's leg. All the other shit I had already decided. Cox was always gonna get vented out. I don't care, I'd made up my mind. And this is the same thing, bro. We don't need to discuss for 5 minutes. Like, I'm good, let's go.
Definitely.
Fucking finally. When Cox sat us down in the mess hall, I thought you were dead. And today in the airlock, I thought we were dead.
I know.
I'm just saying, you're not allowed to die on me, Kamina Drummer. Because I'm not losing the one person in the belt I give a shit about.
Well, that doesn't look good.
What the hell?
Is that something approaching us, or what exactly? Because I have no idea what the fuck we're looking at. That's cute.
Captain, you're gonna want to see this.
There's nothing on the map. No record of any settlements. So what the fuck is that?
Oh. You know, I was fully planning to, like, place a cut in the middle of the recording, but this works, too. The Expanse, fast forward. Same, or skip, rather. Same reason as before. Concierge. Alright, hold up. Just a second. We fucked Maya. Obviously. Just... Alright. Concierge. 43%, the laser crystal drummer found aided Concierge. Only 43%, interesting. Virgil trust level. Drummer told Arlen and Rain that she trusts Virgil. Drummer told Arlen and Rain she wasn't sure. And Drummer and Arlen never discussed. Now 60% said they trust Virgil. That's good. Maya's surgery story. Drummer heard the whole story of Khan's surgery from Maya. Yeah. She fucking... one-armed lady just wreaking havoc after a fucking surgery. Alright. Khan Bao's story. Drummer gifted Khan a cigar and learned about her past. 73%. 0% found the cigar but didn't give it to her. And 27% didn't find the cigar. Right. Arlen's medication. 64%. Drummer didn't find medication. Yeah, because I fucking missed it. And 36% found it and gave it to him, right? 78% gave the mushroom powder to Virgil. It's always 0% that finds the powder, or finds the item, but never gives it to the person. That's interesting. Virgil's past. 48% of people Drummer talked to Virgil about his past. 2% didn't talk to Virgil about his past. 50% didn't discover anything about his past. Okay. Maya's song. Drummer listened to Maya's music with her, obviously. Obviously, 87%, obviously. And scotch for Cox. Oh, yeah, 27% Cox wasn't in the brig. Yeah, because he's kind of dead. 26% Drummer didn't give Cox anything, and 47% Drummer gave Cox his bottle of scotch. Yeah, if you want to be nice to him, but we could just kind of kill him anyway. Relationship with Maya. Drummer spent the night with Maya. 85%, baby. Hell yeah. That is how you do it. All right. All right, let's move on. Wait, is it going to start immediately into the next episode? Fuck. All right. Video ending.